is a stressful place. New York is a stressful place to be living. It's something we always hear, but let's break down what that means and what it looks like. The stress of New York? It's beauty and pain. It's waking up at 5:30 a.m., knowing that there are hundreds of people who woke up hours before you, and thousands who are still partying. It's getting rejected from 30 jobs, and accepted at 1 3 days before you give up on your dreams of staying. It's standing on a subway car for 45 minutes to see something you've never dreamed of seeing. It's meeting the weirdest, most unique people you keep bumping into. New York's different to any other place I've been, and it's taught me to grow up faster than ever. Something I wrote in my journal this morning, because I don't know, this past week has been a little bit rough. I am planning to stay over the summer and have been having a difficult time finding any jobs because everyone is so fixated on staying here because it's such a cool place to be. And it's very difficult to find stuff to do, to make money. And it's not even like what I really want to be going to. It's just like working in any field is pretty challenging right now. The job market's not so great. But then with that thought, I've been doing a lot of reflection about my time here over the past 8 or 9 months, or maybe it's been closer to 7. And it's just very special. Like, sometimes I feel like I'm not cut out to live here. It's too fast-paced. I'm not ambitious enough. I'm not doing enough. But then I kind of remind myself about how much I've learned and what I've learned and why it's important that I kind of submerge myself in an area that keeps teaching me these types of things. I feel like the amount of growth that I've been able to undergo on a cognitive level has been great. I've been able to kind of break out of a myopic view of creativity through using film, which is still something I'm super passionate about. And I've been able to kind of connect with really neat, unique people. But I've only been here for 6 months. And there's sometimes this misconception where you like come to New York and you can be here for 6 months and see everything, meet everyone, make a lot of like really, really solid friends, and make a lot of good work connections that will help you stay in the city. And I don't know how truthful that is. It's not so easy to, because it's such a big city, people are always very busy and like on the go, that it's often difficult to catch people. But if you're willing to like invest time and stick with it, I think in the long run, it really pays off. So I'm really kind of trying to shift my mindset into like, oh, things aren't working out, like I'm not able to find a job, all of this, all of that, like right now. But I think it's probably productive that I kind of shift that thinking from this isn't working out right now. If it doesn't work out right now, then I'm wrong, I'm bad, I'm not proficient, I'm not worthy, into more of a space like, where can I work on, what can I do to alleviate myself and extricate myself from like these like bad emotions and bad feelings, and where can I like continue to keep living here without being stressed. So I feel like I do need to make a money maker. I need to find a money maker, definitely, because I need to pay rent. But it's okay. I'm 19 years old. It's my second year being in school. I don't need to know what I have to do. I'm gonna just figure it out and keep learning.